Why spend Groundhog Day all by yourself? Hello there, my name is Tay-Tay and I'll be your host today. And on this week's Odd Movie Comparisons, we pit Amazon's latest time loop love stories against each other. It's Palm Springs versus the map of tiny perfect things. Roll the clips! First on the docket, 2020's Palm Springs starts off with Niall, who has been stuck in a time loop for ages as a wedding guest. And using the power of his clairvoyance, he attracts Sarah, the sister of the bride.
You are not alone.
I don't think that we met. I'm Sarah.
Niles.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice.
On a magical date, Sarah enters a cave looking for Niles and enters the time loop herself, thus beginning their journey to figure out an escape, and yet finding a way to fall in love. I know, I'm a sucker for romance, but this is honestly one of the best movies I've seen in 2020, and it never got the credit it deserved.
What is going on? Hey, get out of the water!
Guess you followed me.
It's one of those infinite time loop situations you might have heard about.
That I might have heard about?
Fast forward to 2021. The Map of Tiny Perfect Things is adapted from a short story to the big screen for all the teen drama lovers out there.
So I met this girl.
Hi.
I'm Mark.
Dude, I saw you last night. You didn't tell me anything about it.
Like Palm Springs, it starts off with our male protagonist, Mark, who has been stuck in a time loop for ages, reliving the same day again and again, until one day, he finds a young girl by the name of Margaret who doesn't follow the same patterns as everyone else. Like him, Margaret is also someone who's just a victim of the time loop. You know what? It was surprisingly good, especially in a world where teen dramas often fall under expectations for anybody who has graduated high school. And the climax here hits teen girls just as hard as a grown man like me.
Just hoping we could talk about your future.
Besides, who knows what they want to be when they're 17?
I do. Aerospace engineer, specifically a NASA mission specialist.
Wait, like an astronaut? Because that's cool. That's like a...
There are so many similarities in these two movies, but let's list off a few. A Save the Cat intro featuring a nihilistic male protagonist who has given up on escaping the time loop? Check. A female protagonist figuring out the path of escape from the time loop? Check. Distributed by Amazon in an effort to milk two scripts for the price of one? Double check. While they both put a lovey-dovey spin on Murray's Groundhog Day, they take a very different approach to how they want to do it, which was great considering I had to watch them both. Palm Springs is goofy, adult, and occasionally annoying as a 1.5 hour movie of Andy Samberg can be. But matched with Cristin Milioti from How I Met Your Mother, they're oddly compatible in a wacky, yet cute kind of way. It was really well paced, and the light twist and humor, along with J.K. Simmons, pieced the movie together in a very sweet package.
You just have to embrace the fact that nothing matters.
Do you sleep with people in here?
Great question.
I have, but it takes a lot of work.
May I cut in? It's the first dance.
As a romance, though, I felt the storyline between our two lovebirds never fully came into fruition, as their conflicts lacked depth and believability, ultimately leading to a good climax, but not a great one. Back to our other Amazon counterpart. As I said earlier, The Map of Tiny Perfect Things is a teen drama, but Kyle Allen and Kathryn Newton is extremely well casted as they embody the awkwardness, yet the magic of being trapped in a time loop as teenagers. While this movie does drag at 1 hour and 40 minutes, they use the time to add depth and tension to the love story, which I honestly felt was better crafted than Palm Springs.
This is not time. Time is the stuff that when you spend it, you don't get it back.
I thought everything was perfect, but there's more to the story than that.
It knows exactly what it is, and even jabs a few references to Groundhog Day inside the movie. Contrary to Palm Springs, it mixes a bag of emotions, from humor to sadness, and then to joy. And of course, it wraps it up in a sentimental climax. So who takes prime in this Amazon time loop tale of love? While I enjoyed The Map of Tiny Perfect Things as a better love story, the overall cinematics and production of Palm Springs was just really well put together. It is honestly one of the best movies of 2020, which is why I recommend Palm Springs to anybody who loves movies, and which is also why Palm Springs takes this week's Odd Movie Comparisons.
There's a bomb in the cake.
Don't worry, I used to be a bomb guy.
Stand back!
So did I get it right or did I get it wrong? Leave a comment below and let me know. And until next time, keep that popcorn warm for me.